Hey everyone, it's Richard Metalfan here, bringing you guys another old school album review considering the Black Dahlia Murder discography. And today we're going to be talking about Defloraate, the band's fourth album released in the year 2009. With this album, is of course the follow-up to, in my opinion, my favorite album of theirs, Nocturnal. And with this album, they kind of have a little bit of a lineup change. They had like a different lead guitarist. Their old guitarist, John Kempinen, had sort of left the band. He actually quit right before they kind of went on a tour. So they did one tour as a four-piece, but instead they got replacing him was Ryan Knight, the first album with him on lead guitar, formerly of Arsis. And he actually does a really good job filling in the shoes. Obviously, usually when band members have like different lineup changes, there's sometimes it would work, sometimes it wouldn't, but either way, I feel like it works for Black Dahlia. I mean, despite all the lineup changes and different things they've done, I feel like they just never disappoint, but yeah. Yeah, let's just dive into this track by track. Starting things off is Black Valor, starting off with just incredible great drum beats by former drummer Shannon Lucas, and the riffs tend to be fast tremolo-picked pieces or slower palm-muted ones and just very good Gothenburg influences have been turned down a little bit on this album compared to like Nocturnal. Perhaps like the band is starting to sort of like develop like their sound into something a bit more original while sort of like keeping the elements of like familiar bands. And this is pretty much one of the best ways to start off this album. And then starting next song on here is Necropolis, which starts off with some catchy palm muted chugging riffs and then a really great stream from Trevor Sternad, and his vocal style has very constant ridicule ranging from like intolerable to underdeveloped, but I personally find this hybrid style extremely refreshing to the scene, and I like sort of like it almost kind of like reminds me a little bit of like the combination of Chuck Schuldiner on like Symbolic or Sound of Perseverance, and also a little bit of like Frank Mullen a little bit on more like modern Suffocation releases. That's pretty much what it reminds me of when I hear Trevor's voice on this, but overall great song. Moving on to the next song here, which is A Selection Unnatural, which I believe Shannon's drumming is again excellent throughout this and he drives the beast forward with an alright blasting and impeccable double bass pummel. And just I really love like the twin guitar leads of like Brian and Ryan. It just almost kind of reminds me of like pure 80s thrash-esque, and I just love how the really good bass line in there from Bart, aka Ryan Williams. Moving on to the next two songs being Denounced, Degrace, and Christ Deformed, which I feel like these two songs are positively air guitar-able cuts, as they both some very tasty guitar picking, and one has like juicy lumbering riffs as some like bleh, very crusty sounding. It's almost kind of like reminds me of like the vocals kind of remind me a little bit of like Dying Fetus and Misery Index a bit, and the other has sort of like a blistering bus all riff to complement it, and it has a good booming rhythms perfectly, and it also has some really great ripping solos in here. Overall good song. Anyway, moving on to the next song on here, which is Death Panorama, which is the group's fastest blasting song, which just equally is just thrilling, is crushing, and it just packs everything that Black Dahlia has done in less than 2 minutes. Throne of Lunacy, which kind of reaches a bit more of the traditional sound in line with sort of like stock home scene and sort of like a handful of like American affiliates in like the mid-90s, but still contains a fair amount of those predictable melodic cliches and sweep happy guitars. In fact, the lead guitar part is primarily where the band does a great job channeling a sound which is, I don't know, just very almost technical sounding. Anyway, moving on to I can't even speak today. I'm sorry, I'm really out of it. Anyway, moving on to Eyes of a Thousand, which is yet another exhilarating high-octane number that is filled with just blood-pumping, mosh-ready riffage, just some really great blast beats and a solid bass lines, and there's a really cool part near the end where the music and the rest of the band sort of like drops off, leaving just an a cappella vocal part with just some snarly skin-crawling, yet which is very intelligible, but kind of like almost very black metal-esque raps, which is good. Anyway, The Witch Erodes the Most Tender of Things. Try saying that 5 times fast, is a crushing cavalcade of chunky, crushing riffs and just machine gun double bass he's drumming. And the arrangements are allowed to breathe a little bit here, though, as the song does adopt a little bit of a fastic guitar melodicism. And the solo sections is one for the books. It kind of reminds you a little bit of like Heartwork Metallica-esque Carcass and Darkest Hour and early In Flames and Faceless, and sometimes even a little bit of like Iron Maiden. It's very technical, winding, complex, and terrifically memorable. And this is one of the Black Dahlia Murder's best guitar soloing to date. Anyway, then closing the album is I Will Return, which is about 5 minutes in length, and it is a very epic way to end this album. It begins with a nice harmonic intro before morphing into its usual beastie self. Hell, that's a great way to end this album. Now overall, Death Will Rape by Black Dahlia Murder is really good, pretty good album. It's really hard, even like topping one of their magnus opus, Nocturnal. So if I have to give this album a score, I'm going to give this probably a solid 9 out of 10. Yep, that's my review of Death Will Rape by Black Dahlia Murder, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know in the comments what you guys think about it. And I'll see you all in the next video. And as always, keep it metal.